started jumping out of airplanes or started taking lessons to jump out of airplanes when I was 17 years old, and I took lessons and everything and then never did it simply because of sheer fear, you know, and apprehensiveness. I just got scared and never went through with it. I took lessons one weekend, the next weekend I was going to jump, the weather was bad, so I took some more lessons. The next weekend the weather was bad, the next weekend I just didn't show up. And all of a sudden when I was 25 years old, I went out and didn't even take lessons. Back then the sport was a little bit more lax and a little bit less rigid and less regimented than what it is today, and I was able to go out with some friends of mine that were already skydivers, and they just put the gear on me and took me up and threw me out of an aircraft. And I guess from that time on, it was a combination of the exhilarating feeling and the fear and the feeling of accomplishment. Know that I don't consider what I do living on the edge quite in the same context that you're asking the question. I suppose if I was forced to look at it in that respect, I would have to say, yeah, I guess it is. But on the other hand, getting on the Highway 45 to drive out here to Friendswood and the kind of weather I drove out in today, in my opinion, is a lot more dangerous and pretty darned unforgiving of stupid mistakes also to drive this 30-40 miles out here to Friendswood. I don't do things, at least I don't think, okay? Maybe there's some subconscious thing inside of me that I'm not even aware of, you know, and it'd probably take a team of psychiatrists to dig it out of me, which probably wouldn't hurt me any, but the point I'm trying to make is I don't do things because I think they're dangerous. I do things because they're fun and because they're exciting and because they're important to me. You know, I don't go out and go all out to make 7 or 8 or 10 jumps a day. Number one, it's too expensive. Number two, it's too much work and too much effort. And I'm out there to have fun and enjoy myself. If I was in competition, you know, training for something, it would be different, but that's not what I'm doing. So those days are pretty much over for me. You know, I don't compete anymore other than just with myself.
What kind of awards did you win when you were competing?
A couple of trophies for sequential and I never won one for accuracy, but I won two different trophies for sequential, one for 10-man, for the 10-man team, and one for a 4-man team that I was on in 1972 for a Labor Day meet.
They do drink liquor out on the range.
I'm probably guilty of it more than some jumpers, and I shouldn't do it, and it's wrong because it's taking an unnecessary chance. It's exposing yourself to a risk that you shouldn't be exposed to. That's more in the nature of I don't know how to say it. I guess we all do things that we're not supposed to do, and we all break rules that we shouldn't break. That doesn't make it okay, and it doesn't make it right, and I wouldn't advocate that, nor would I indicate even for a moment that your average skydiver doesn't. I do think there was a time in my jumping career, the time that I came up in, and when I first started jumping out of airplanes, when there were a lot more skydivers that did that sort of thing than what do it today. Skydiving over the years that I've jumped has become a lot safer, it's become a lot more serious, it's become a lot less macho. All skydivers should be licensed, and every jump to be legally recognized, just like a pilot's logbook, when he logs his hours when he flies, has got to be signed off by another licensed skydiver, which is almost the same as a notary. It's just about as important, well, if maybe not as important. So it's everything to a skydiver. If I were to go to a different state or a different city, a different drop zone, in order to be recognized as a qualified, competent skydiver, because any idiot can go out and buy the most sophisticated skydiving gear to be bought, because the skydiving companies, the people that sell parachuting equipment, they don't care who they sell it to. You know, if you can write them a check and fill in the order blank, you can order the most sophisticated parachuting gear in the world, but it does not make you a skydiver. Your logbook are your credentials. It's just like a passport.